You want to start to paint on clothes but you don't know how? I will tell you all the tips and tricks of painting on clothes, and also I will answer the questions about the painting process. So if you are interested, please keep watching this video. Hi everyone, this is Daria, the artist who paints on clothes. And in this video, I will tell the tips and tricks of painting on clothes. I will answer the questions I receive on my Instagram about painting process, and also I will tell you about the challenges you can face while trying to paint on clothes. I've already shared the video about fabric paints I use. Check it out if you haven't watched it yet. And I prepared a note for myself to not forget anything. So let's get started. The first question is, can I use acrylic paints or oil paints for paint on clothes? My answer is no, because there are a lot of beautiful fabric paints being produced, so why you will use acrylic or even oil paints to paint and you will take this risk that something will happen with your painting after the washing? If you can buy fabric paints and you will be sure that it will be so easy for you to paint and nothing will happen with your painting after the washing. There is no difference in price between acrylic paints and fabric paints. So if you want to paint on clothes, buy fabric paints and you won't have any problems. The second question is, what kind of brushes do you use for paint on clothes? And actually there are not many differences between painting on canvas and painting on clothes. I mean, you use the same brushes. And I will show you the brushes I use. Actually there are just 4 brushes I have. And now mine doesn't look a bit old and ugly because I paint with brushes until I can't paint with them anymore. I love to paint with such brushes. So as you can see, here is 3 rounded brushes and 1 big flat brush I have. Little size brush I use for the details. Medium size brush I use to paint an object. And big flat brush I use for the background. And this rounded brush, I use it for splattering. I forgot to wash it after the painting and became so hard, but it's perfect for the splattering the paints. The third question is, which fabrics are the best for the painting? I recommend to use natural fabrics like cotton fabric. Don't choose fabric with relief, but choose a smooth fabric so it will be much more easy for you to paint. For example, shirts I paint on, it's poplin fabric and it's so smooth, so it's so easy to paint on these shorts. T-shirt fabric is not the same smooth, so it's a bit harder to paint on them. Denim also not so easy, and also you can paint on the leather fabric, and I have never painted on the leather, but I will try soon and I'm sure it will be so easy because the leather is so smooth. So if you're a beginner for the painting, choose smooth natural fabric. The fourth question is, why do you use a mannequin? Here is my mannequin near me. Why do you use a mannequin for painting? Is it the easiest way to paint? Okay, my answer is no, it's not the easiest way to paint. But as you can understand, I'm trying to make the art of the hand painting clothing popular. So I shoot a lot of videos for my YouTube channel and also for Instagram. So I think that my painting on the mannequin is more spectacular than I would paint on the table. But it's not easy because clothing not fixed and it's moving sometimes when you're painting. So to paint on the table will be more easy for you if you are a beginner. And you should put a cardboard inside of your clothing and fix the clothing. So this way the clothes won't move and it will be more easy for you to paint. But what is good about painting on the mannequin that I can move away from it and look to the composition I painted, and if I didn't like it, I can change it, I can make something bigger or smaller. But for me, it's really necessary because I create complicated designs. It both is hard and also it's easy to paint on the mannequin. But if you're a beginner, paint on the table. The next question is, do you need any special diluter to dilute fabric paints? No, you don't need any special diluter. You dilute fabric paints with water like the acrylic paint, no difference. So just water. The last question is, how to fix the painting? You need to fix the painting with an iron, but first you should wait until your painting will get dry for 24 hours. Then you should iron the painting on the reverse side. It's very important. You shouldn't push the iron to the painting. It's so cruel for your artwork. You should iron on the reverse side for 5 minutes, or you can put some thin fabric on the painting and you will iron through it. Then you can wash your clothing without any problems. So let's come to the problems, to the challenges you can face while trying to paint on clothes. The first is I received a lot of messages about how do you paint on the black fabric. It's so hard to paint on the black clothes. To paint on the black clothes is the same easy as to paint on the white clothes, but because of wrong technique, it can be so hard because many people do not create an undercoat. Look to all the videos on my YouTube channel where I paint on the black clothes. First, I create an undercoat and I use for undercoat the white fabric paint. The undercoat is so important because if you didn't create an undercoat, you need to put so many layers to make your colors look vivid. But if you created an undercoat, you don't need many layers because your colors will look vivid as you paint on the white surface. And one more important thing about the undercoat, that you should let it dry for an hour, then you can continue to paint. Because if you will paint on the wet undercoat, it is a risk that all the layers will wash off after the washing. But if you will let it dry for an hour, there is no problem will be with washing at all. So it is very important, don't forget, let it dry, then continue to paint. The one more problem you can face when you paint on the black fabric is that the paints are cracking. If you don't create an undercoat and you put so many layers to make colors look vivid, plus you don't use enough water to dilute your paints, so many layers and paints are so dry, and the result, paints are cracking. So create an undercoat, use a little amount of water to dilute your paints, and you won't have this problem about cracking paints. So let's come to the tips and tricks. For my designs, I love to paint the background. I use big flat brush for the background and I paint directional brush strokes. So if it's a winged lion flying or the Pegasus, it makes the effect of the movement, and I think it is so beautiful and so special. And you can't print this way, so it's a huge difference between hand painting clothing and printing clothing. And one more thing which I love to add to my designs is the paint splatters. I already showed you this brush I use for the paint splatters, and sometimes I use just one color, for example white stars, so it's like a snow, or sometimes I use all the rainbow colors, so it makes such an artistic, beautiful, colorful effect. And I think that the paint splatters is like a unique touch, and it makes hand painting clothing so special. And one more effect you can create on the hand painted clothing is a watercolor effect background. I don't use this effect much because it's not appropriate for my painting style, but it is also so beautiful. And to create this effect, you need to mix fabric paints with a big amount of water and use the brush for the watercolor for this effect. So this way you can create amazing, beautiful, colorful background for your design. And the last trick is that you can use the fabric outliners to create the volume lines on the clothes. For example, I use the outliners to create the spider web on the spider's design, and I add the volume to the line, so it's made the design much more interesting. So sometimes I think that such outliners are very necessary. These outliners are the Russian brand Decola. I bought them in Russia. But the brand of the fabric paints I use, Pebeo, also produce such outliners. So if you want to create some beautiful lines, you should definitely buy the outliners. So that's all for today. But if you are a beginner and if you will just begin to paint on clothes, I'm sure you will face some different challenges, or maybe you will have some questions which I didn't answer in this video. So feel free to write to me in the comments here on the YouTube, or write to me on my Instagram. I'm there, Dire Creative. I'm always happy to help because I really want to make the art of the hand painted clothing popular, and I want more artists begin to paint on clothes. And if you are new here, subscribe to my channel. I share a lot of process videos, and also hit the like button if you found this video useful. Hope to see you again. Bye bye.